Anke Pizzala, 8 German Nobel Prize winners over the last decade. Is that actually pure chance?
No, I think that's also due to the good organization we actually have in our scientific landscape. I think that, for instance, in the Helmholtz Association, we have a very good promotion of young scientists. So what we do is we really look for the best in a very early age, and mm-hmm. we try to even make real young people and or even pupil in the kindergarten interested in science.
Harald Zuhausen was still complaining about the way he was being helped as a younger scientist. So things have changed.
I think so. Yeah. I think things have changed really strongly. So we really have programs. We have tenure track programs for excellent young mm-hmm. scientists. We have programs where we cooperate with neighboring universities very strongly. We have programs where we cooperate with partners also on an international scale.
If you look further into the future, I mean, the Helmholtz Association does a lot of work in the field of basic research, but now politics is always looking at the applied sciences in order to help their economy. I mean, do you think the financing will be safe in the future for basic research?
We actually do think that basic research is absolutely necessary to do good technology transfer. Mm-hmm. And we think excellent basic research, and we transfer it via good organizational structures into technology. Mm-hmm. Let me give you an example. At our institute, we work on sun farm photovoltaics, and we do fundamental research there in our center, and we do technology transfer versus a competence center in the field, which directly leads to applications in industry.
Thanks a lot for the talk, Anke Pizzala.
Thank you.